Safe Berks on BCTV is supported by Visions Federal Credit Union.
Thank you for tuning into Safe Berks on BCTV. My name is Dacey Horohoe, and I currently serve as the Community Relations and Resource Manager at Safe Berks. I want to thank the sponsor of our show, Visions Federal Credit Union. Safe Berks is the local nonprofit that serves survivors of domestic violence and sexual assault. Our services are free, confidential, and available 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. Our services are available in English and Spanish and will be translated into any language necessary. Our services include shelter, our 24-hour hotline and text line, counseling, legal services, community outreach and response, medical advocacy, and education. Our 24-hour hotline is 844-789-SAFE or 7233. Or anyone who needs help can also text the words Safe Berks to 20121. We are here to help. Today, I am honored to interview Mereliss Colon-Ortiz, our COO, and Beth Garrigan, our CEO. Welcome, Mereliss and Beth, to the show.
Thank you.
Thank you for everything you do for the survivors, their families, and for Safe Berks as an agency. Mereliss, we recently finalized our strategic plan, which is the result of collaborative efforts of staff, leadership, and board members. The plan summarizes a bold but achievable mission, vision for the future of Safe Berks. Can you give us a brief overview of Safe Berks values and how these guide us to work on our plan?
Sure. I'm going to be talking about our values, and it's great that we start with the values because it's really how we work on a daily basis. We like to keep our values in mind in every interaction with each other as far as staff and with the clients that we serve. So I have them here. I'm going to be reading them because I don't know them by heart. We have five of them. The first one is safety. We believe that freedom from physical, emotional, spiritual, and psychological harm is a basic human right of all individuals. We know that domestic violence, sexual assault, oppression, and privilege include power-based tactics that affect physical, emotional, and psychological safety, and we work to help survivors heal the wounds caused by power-based violence. The second one is respect. We value the dignity of all individuals while appreciating our differences and celebrating and honoring our diversity. Respect is reflected in the way we treat our clients, ourselves, and members of the community. We believe our work requires us to reach out to marginalized individuals and communities and to create space to celebrate and nurture them. Next one is empowerment. We believe empowerment begins with recognizing and knowing that individually and collectively, Safe Berks clients, staff, and volunteers have the strength to make necessary change and to accomplish our goals. We recognize that success is defined by each individual giving their experiences, talents, and culture, and we celebrate this success. The next one is education. We will educate ourselves and our community to reject and prevent violence and oppression in our own lives and in the lives of the people around us. We recognize that our mission and values are transformational, and we must work with intention to break down social and cultural norms that continue to divide us. And the last one is hope. We believe that hope is key to our existence, to our ability to preserve and to achieve goals. We recognize that our work fosters hope and resilience and improves physical, emotional, spiritual, and psychological well-being.
Thank you for sharing that. I think those are, like you said, wonderful values that guide us every day, both in our personal and professional lives.
Yes, and I'm sure that as viewers are either watching us or seeing us, if you don't remember them because of everything I just read was a lot, you can find them in our website and you can look through them and see that we're trying to really work on a daily basis following these values. It's really what we believe in.
Yeah. All right, Beth, thank you for joining us. Can you share with our viewers Safe Berks whys, along with this mission and vision for the organization and how they will guide our work on the strategic plan?
Absolutely. We know what we do and how we do it, but a few years ago we spent a considerable amount of time talking about why we do it. And as an organization, we collectively chose four whys. Our whys are people who are hurt need to know that it is not their fault and it is okay to ask for help. We should all feel safe and valued. Knowledge is powerful, and children need positive role models. Our whys enable us to focus our efforts on what matters most, and they compel us to take risks and push forward despite potential barriers and obstacles that may arise. Our strategic plan is our roadmap on that journey of pushing forward. Our whys drive us to work harder for survivors in our community and to continue saving lives and building our future. They also support our work to further our mission to provide a safe haven and support for victims of domestic violence and sexual assault through education, advocacy, and a relentless commitment to preventing abuse. We are dedicated to fostering an inclusive environment where individuals can be their true selves and feel empowered to stand up to oppression of all kinds and reach our vision of Berks County having zero tolerance for domestic violence and sexual assault.
Thank you, Beth. All right, Mereliss, as our COO, you play an important role in ensuring our long-range strategies in the strategic plan and that they are achieved. Can you speak to our strategies that focus on staff retention and equity and inclusion?
Sure. So we're focusing our recruiting efforts on individuals seeking formal internships, experimental learning, and volunteer opportunities. We feel we can offer a great learning experience and know from experience that many of our volunteers and interns become an employee at Safe Berks. We're excited to share that thanks to the partnerships we have developed with local colleges, and Dacey, you've been very helpful with that. We're going to be having three interns very soon in our residential MAP and education departments. That's very exciting news. We are fostering an organization-wide focus on and commitment on retention. That's very important to us. And we believe that employee retention is the responsibility of all staff at Safe Berks. It's not an HR issue only. We're all in this together. And it's about making people feel welcome and supported. That's one of the most important parts that will keep staff coming back and deal with all the challenges that we deal with the clients and survivors that we serve. We're expanding our equity and inclusion initiatives to become what we are rather than what we do. We're currently focusing on developing employee resource groups. These are voluntary employee-led groups whose aim is to foster a diverse, inclusive workplace aligned with the organizations they serve. Our groups will be led and participated in by employees who share a characteristic, whether it's gender, ethnicity, religious affiliation, lifestyles, or interest, and they will provide staff with opportunities to develop leadership skills, learn about other cultures, and build relationships across the company. Our goal is for these groups to be leading us into more inclusive agency policies and more positive work environment, support greater diversity, leading to more varied ideas and perspectives, which will ultimately improve the services we provide survivors.
Absolutely. All right, Beth, as the CEO of Safe Berks, you are leading the organization through the strategies and driving towards the vision. Can you go into a bit more depth about the strategies that focus on expanding our housing capacity, meeting the needs of the greater community, and designing the service delivery model of the future?
Sure. We recently received a PA Housing Affordability and Rehabilitation Enhancement Fund, or FAIR, much easier to say, grant, which is supporting critical expansion efforts in our safe house. Over the past 3 years, we've been at or over capacity in our safe house and desperately needed more space. So we will be, with the help of this grant, expanding space to include 6 additional bedrooms, which we are very excited about. In addition to that, as we're renovating the space, we also enhanced our services within the safe house so that we can provide more comprehensive service delivery to survivors from the moment they reach out to us in crisis and through their exit plan. We're also focusing attention on identifying and eliminating barriers to survivors receiving services or even seeking services. Over the past year, we have tried to expand our presence all over Berks County and are currently at over 25 locations throughout Berks County so we can meet survivors where they are. In addition to that, the challenge of possibly coming into our facility to get services, we are looking at ways to enhance our facility so that it is more accommodating to individuals with physical disabilities. We're also working to find ways to help survivors that have pets, and many other barriers to receiving treatment or services. We are focusing our efforts on that. We are approximately 80% grant funded, which presents some challenges, as we recently learned with the Pennsylvania state budget impasse. That put funding in jeopardy, which then ultimately impacts our ability to provide services to survivors, and we don't want that to happen. So part of our strategic plan is looking at ways to develop diverse revenue streams. The other challenge we face with grant funding is that those grants do not always cover what we need them to cover. And with some of our state and federal funding for domestic violence and sexual assault, if it continues to be level funding, that's very challenging when we're seeing more survivors seeking service and we're not receiving more funding. We're also looking at ways, some of our current ways that we raise money is through Peace Trust membership. So we're looking to grow that membership. And also we will be launching a Shop Safe Berks. So stay tuned for more details about that. We're excited about that. But a lot of different ways that we can bring additional funding into the organization so that we can meet survivors' needs.
Awesome. All right. Thanks for sharing. Those are all super important things. The Shop Safe Berks is super exciting, like she said. So definitely stay tuned to that for all of your needs. All right. Mereliss, how will we properly evaluate the effectiveness and progress towards staff retention and equity and inclusion?
And this is an ongoing, these are ongoing efforts, and we're always looking closely into this. But hopefully, right? By the lower percentage of turnover, hopefully that will lower, lower number of open positions at the end of each month, shorten the average days required to fill one position, increase employee satisfactions with our total reward package. It's very good. We do have very good benefits for staff and other rewards. Increase staff participation at the agency's DE&I efforts and trainings, different events that we have, and positive engagement survey results, and increased number of diverse applicants.
Beth, how can we tell if Safe Berks is successfully expanding our housing capacity, meeting the needs of our greater community, and working towards the service delivery model of the future?
Well, hopefully we will announce when the bedrooms are done and can hopefully show some pictures of those renovated bedrooms before they start becoming occupied, which will happen quickly. Mm-hmm. We will hopefully see, and I'm positive we will see, an increase in the number of survivors that come to Safe Berks and reach out to Safe Berks. We will be at more locations throughout Berks County. We're constantly looking for community organizations that want to partner with us or would like us to provide information or possibly even be on site to provide services to those you serve. And we are certainly hoping to see a decrease in our dependence on grant funding, or at least the state and federal level grant funding. We want to be able to grow into the future and have less dependence on those grants so that we can make sure that we're doing whatever we need to do to serve survivors in Berks County.
Thank you. All right, Mereliss, how can the community directly influence how we are serving others at Safe Berks?
Oh, the community. We really need our community, and they are such supporters of the agency, so their support is much needed and greatly appreciated. What the community can do, definitely spread the word about who we are and what we do. If there's any community members that would like to learn more about Safe Berks, they can definitely reach out to any of us, and we can meet with you and discuss more about what we do and how you can get involved. We need community support. We want to eliminate the stigma and talk about it. We want everyone to understand the devastating trauma that our survivors experience. And we want Berks County to have zero tolerance for domestic violence and sexual assault.
That is true. And community right now, I know we are doing a towel drive at Baja Beach Tanning. So if you have any towels and you are a Baja Beach member, or if you're not a Baja Beach member, please feel free to bring those towels to Baja Beach. They come in great need for our survivors. All right, Beth, what are Safe Berks' greatest needs right now?
Well, we have constant needs. So on our website, we keep, our development department keeps a running list of all of our wish list items, and they change depending on who's in our safe house at the time. So you could check back almost on a daily basis for changes to that list. But that is our most up-to-date list of items that we need. We also have a link to an Amazon wish list and Boscov's gift registry, so people can check those out and see what we need. Almost always we need sheets and pillows, and gift cards are always necessary for those last minute things that we don't have grant funding to cover. Gift cards come in quite handy to help our survivors. And lastly, we need people. We have several job openings, and you can find a link to those job openings on our webpage. It's a very hard job, but extremely rewarding. And as you heard today, we talked a lot about our strategic plan. There are great things to come for Safe Berks. So if you or someone you know is interested in working at Safe Berks, check out our job openings.
Yes, absolutely. Come work with all three of us. It's exciting. All right, Mereliss, how can people learn more about Safe Berks and exactly what we do?
Well, the community or anybody who's interested to learn more about what we do definitely can look us up on the website at www.safeberks.org. If anybody would like to come in to the building and have a meet and greet, definitely contact Mindy McIntosh and set up or coordinate a meeting to come into the building and learn more from what we do and where we are and how we do it in there. We also have, like Beth mentioned earlier, advocates that go into the community and other agencies. So if you're interested in having an advocate go to your agency or your space to learn or give an educational group or give more information on the agency, definitely reach out to the agency and we'll coordinate those and set that up. But yeah, look us up, look at us also on Facebook, because we do put information in there as to where are we and what we're doing. So look us up on social media. Also, if you go on YouTube, you can see previous BCTV shows. You can learn more about other things that we've been doing, and you can just learn more that way. So go to the website, give us a call to schedule or coordinate a meeting with us, or try to coordinate an advocate to come to your space so that they can talk a little bit more about what we do.
Yes, that is true. We do things such as lunch and learns, and we're always going to different sites, so we are happy to go to any site. I, for myself, was at an event on Friday that was at a financial planning open house where we received a ton of towel donations, and it was a wonderful event despite the weather. All right, so as our show is coming to a close, I want to thank Mereliss and Beth for everything you do for survivors and their families. I wanted to quickly speak about our next event, which is Silent Witness. That will be happening on Monday, October 16th, beginning at 255 Chestnut Street, which is one of our locations, at 11 a.m. This somber yet powerful event helps us visualize those lives lost to domestic homicide over the years. This event is free and open to the public. We encourage our community to take part and to please help honor those who are lost. For more information about the event, you can visit www.safeberks.com/events or email me, Dacey, at Dacey, H-D-A-C-E-Y-H, at safeberks.org. I want to remind everyone that Safe Berks is available to help survivors of domestic violence and sexual assault 24 hours a day, every day of the year. Free services include our safe house, counseling, legal services, community outreach and response, and education. Our 24-hour hotline number is 844-789-SAFE, S-A-F-E, or text the words Safe Berks to 20121. Thank you for tuning in. Together, we can build a safe Berks.
Safe Berks on BCTV is supported by Visions Federal Credit Union.